Hey guys, it's Dave. Welcome back to another video. Thanks so much for watching. Today, I really just wanted to get caught up on all this Rocket Lab news we've been having over the past couple weeks. I haven't really had a chance to dive deep into it on a video as of yet. Before we get to that though, I did just want to share that I finally got my copy when the heavens went on sale, or I should say, I got access to it because I did take it out from the library. Maybe I'm weird, but I really love libraries and I feel like people don't use them enough. So I finally grabbed that from the library. If I do love it as much as I expect to, I might end up just buying a copy for myself to go on my shelf and have forever. But yeah, we'll see. I've heard a lot of good things about this book. It covers all the space companies we know and love, the Planet Labs, Rocket Lab, Astra, SpaceX, a lot of these newbies to the space, trying to make it in the space industry and kind of grow this commercial space economy. I expect it to be very interesting, and I think if you're interested in the space as well, you might want to check it out. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider hitting subscribe by the end of the video. Every new subscriber helps a lot. Thank you guys so much. And with that out of the way, let's dive into all these Rocket Lab updates we've had over the past couple weeks. So yeah, a lot of exciting news to cover. First of all, we have some new launch contracts for Rocket Lab. You might have already seen it. And by the way, just before I get into this, I just wanted to give a good shout out to Joe in the Facebook group, Rocket Lab Stockholders. He does a great job of sharing a lot of this same stuff. So if you do want to keep on top of Rocket Lab news, that's a great place to do it. Anyway, I'm also still here if you like to hear my commentary and have it in video format. Rocket Lab was selected to launch Telesat's Low Earth Orbit 3 demonstration satellite no earlier than Q3 of this year. So just another new contract for Rocket Lab, always exciting to see. I believe this is just a one-off though, so not as exciting, but still every launch definitely helps. And then we have another new contract for Rocket Lab where they'll be the launch partner for Capella Space, who is supporting NASA's research efforts. Always love to see those NASA payloads on Rocket Lab rockets. Next up, we have the first HASTE launch for Rocket Lab so soon after the announcement, wasting no time getting going on this. That's the one thing I love to hear when they do make an announcement. It's usually ready to go. We're not talking about some concept way in the future. HASTE was just announced, feels like a couple weeks ago, and we're already launching the first rocket. Now, the launch is planned sometime between June 15 to 20th. There's no live stream planned, and the visitor center will not be open for the launch. Seems like there's a lot of, hush-hush around this mission. It's going to be a suborbital test, but probably for some kind of military or defense purposes. Bit more details. Again, it's a technology demonstration mission. Payload is classified payload to be launched in a suborbital trajectory. Obviously, these Electrons have had small changes made to them versus being used in an orbital fashion, but I still love that we're opening up a whole new kind of line of business for Electron, if you will, and this has been an underserved area of the market. Now, it doesn't need a kick stage, so perhaps a little bit less revenue when it comes to space systems, but from what I'm hearing, it will be around $7.5 million, so that's pretty much the average price of an Electron rocket. And pretty exciting news, Rocket Lab built a, if you're not familiar with it, space factory, it's called, for Varda, and they're going to be working on manufacturing pharmaceuticals in space. The first one of these has just finally launched. It's on a Rocket Lab Photon spacecraft bus platform, and it actually has a re-entry vehicle, so the pharmaceuticals will be made in the low gravity environment of low Earth orbit, and then they'll have to re-enter and come through Earth's atmosphere, land back on Earth. So kind of a test run for figuring out how to do capsules, how to re-enter Earth's atmosphere safely, and a lot of cool stuff going on with this mission. Now, the mission is actually not launching on a Rocket Lab Electron rocket. It is launching on a Falcon 9 rideshare mission. So there's been a lot of debate, is this a good thing? Is this a bad thing that they're launching on Falcon 9? I think it's great personally that they made this platform that can be used in other rockets and they're not just trying to lock it down. It gives more of a market for Photon. It's such a versatile vehicle, can do so many different things, whether it's a kick stage, whether it's a platform for, a space factory, being sent to the moon, being sent to Mars, being sent to Venus, really all sorts of things for this little capable spacecraft. And if you're curious where it is in this little rideshare, this is the inside of the fairing of the Falcon 9, by the way. I believe we're looking at it right here, wrapped in gold. And this part little here is the re-entry capsule that'll re-enter Earth. Now, if you want a bigger image, here's what we're looking at, kind of zoomed in, obviously. This was from Rocket Lab's facilities when they were getting things ready. Obviously, this capsule here being the part that re-enters, and then we have the solar panels, we have the photon, which is the part that it's on. So should still be a lot of good revenue for Rocket Lab's space systems side of the business, even if it isn't launching on Electron. And there's going to be three more of these Photon Varda missions coming up in the future. Love to see it. I really would love to see Photon start to get a lot more use. I know it's something that Rocket Lab has invested a lot of time and effort and money into. It started to pay off, but I would definitely like to see more Photon missions in the future, whether it's commercially for NASA or otherwise. We also have a quick video of the spacecraft deploying from the Falcon 9. Let's take a quick look at the satellite being released. Okay, just a really quick one there, but I think it looks really cool to see. And then we also have a video from Gravity Lab's CEO. He came on a podcast called Off Nominal, which I'm a big fan of, by the way. If you're not too familiar with it and you love space and space companies, I definitely would recommend it's worth a listen. They also have a Main Engine Cutoff podcast. I would check out both of them. But we have a CEO of a company called Gravity Lab. And obviously, you know, every space company with lab in the name, I'm going to be all over. Let's hear what he had to say talking about Rocket Lab's Photon platform. I thought it was pretty cool to hear him talk about it here. He is a former Rocket Lab employee as well, though.
With an exquisite spacecraft bus, you can do missions like Capstone, Lunar Photon. You can do Varda. You can do things like that with ownership of the enabling products for everybody else's space mission. You can make good money and take on very little risk by just plugging yourself into everybody's space mission. And now you're just a juggernaut of space systems where you can supply anything from a mission down to a widget. So like Rocket Lab's been big ass as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah.
Definitely nice to hear all that praise coming from the CEO of another space startup talking about Rocket Lab's Photon platform and how great it is that it can be launched on other rockets and that it's not, you know, in a walled garden type system. Next up, we actually have a bit of internet sleuthing here. So you may have seen this shared around the internet. It's been getting a fair bit of attention lately. The image on the left here is, I believe, from Apple Maps, and a lot of people were thinking that it's the start of the construction of the landing platform here for Neutron out in Wallops. So on the right is what Rocket Lab shared the landing platform would look like out in the water. And then on the left here is this Apple Maps image that's being shared around. People have noticed, oh, it looks like they're starting to build this platform out into the ocean. But a few members of the Discord have been internet sleuthing and digging into this, and it does look like this is not actually Rocket Lab's landing platform taking shape. And I'll show you why right now, but just first of all, thanks so much to Yeti and Austin especially, and really just the investigation of this goes to show the power of the Planet Labs platform. So let's take a closer look here and see why I don't think this is in fact the landing platform for Neutron. Okay, so just a high-level overview, and thanks again to Austin for this. We have in yellow an arrow pointing at the Electron pad. This is in Wallops, obviously, in the area. Purple is the Northrop Grumman Minotaur pad, and then red is the area where the picture was taken. And you can actually see really small the little dock or whatever that is jutting out into the ocean, starting to take shape. I can definitely see why people would think that that is the landing platform. But diving a little bit deeper here, so this is a higher res image from Google Earth. This is taken October 14th, 2022. So a little while ago, but we can see here they have these three wave breaks in black out in the ocean. Now, those were not in the previous picture over here. We don't really see the wave breaks. I know it's a little zoomed out, but we don't see the wave breaks here either. So what's going on? Well, Apple Maps does seem to be a little bit notorious for having older pictures on their site, but we did want to dig a bit deeper and see if we could figure out what's going on. So, first of all, this is another image from a different website where you can kind of see the wave breaks taking shape. We have one out here and this little jutting out. I believe it was being used to help build these breaks and put them out there. At least that's the theory. So we can see it taking shape. There's one of the three already out there in this older picture from a different angle. And now going into Planet Labs, a bit lower resolution image, but the nice thing about them is you have tons of images like every single day. So here's an image from January 22, 2021. So a couple years ago now, and we can see that little thing jutting out into the ocean that a lot of people thought was, you know, the starting of the landing pad. So that's a while back, though. Like, why is it so long ago? It doesn't really make sense for it to be all the way back in the start of 2021, right? Well, looking at a more recent picture here. Now, this is as recent as we can get on Planet Labs, which is June 15th of 2023. So really, just 2 days ago, we have an image of this exact spot. In the circle in yellow is kind of the area. You can even kind of see, it's a little grainy, but you can see the three little wave breaks here in black. If you can zoom in a bit further, you can actually see it better, but I'll keep it at this resolution. So you can see those wave breaks there, but there is no sign of that little dock jutting out into the water. And obviously, you know, if this is pictures from 2 days ago, then that dock can't be in progress as a landing platform for Neutron. Another little item here, the dock we were seeing, I believe, was around here. But in an interview with Peter Beck, we were seeing that the Neutron facilities were planned to be more a little further south over here. So it seems pretty likely to me that this image being shared around is not the Neutron landing pad taking shape, and I can understand why a lot of people thought it was. But thank you so much to Austin and Yeti for clearing that up for us. You guys are the best. I am going to double your salary after this video. One point, though, I will say from these pictures is we're not seeing, much in the way of Neutron facilities taking shape as of yet in terms of the launch pad, landing pad, that kind of stuff. Maybe that's a little disappointing to some of us, but we do still have some progress for Neutron to take a look at. Recent tweet here from Peter Beck just the other day saying that the second stage test stand is taking shape for cryogenic structural stage testing. So pretty soon we're going to start to see some tanks with that icy cryogenically cooled fuels, which is definitely a good sign for progress. One of the key indicators we're looking for to see that Neutron is really taking shape. As well, we had another tweet from Rocket Lab on June 6th talking about their Archimedes engine, talking about how Archimedes components, including injectors and combustion chambers, are being 3D printed from the giant machines in Rocket Lab headquarters, putting their extensive additive manufacturing experience to use on these new engines. So progress on engines and progress on tanks are two of the biggest things we really want to see for Neutron taking shape. Obviously, launch pads and landing pads would be nice as well. Those need to start coming pretty soon. But kind of the biggest items for a rocket is you're looking at your propulsion, and obviously you got to test your tanks and make sure they can withstand the pressures. So those two items both coming along well, and I think I'm probably going to make a dedicated video on Neutron progress pretty soon in the future. And just to wrap up, we did have a bunch of interviews and conferences definitely worth checking out if you want to hear more from Rocket Lab employees and management. We had Frank, a program manager at Rocket Lab, speaking at Space Tech Expo. If you want to check that out, I'll be sure to share a link in the description down below. As well, Peter Beck himself, the man, had a interview on Wish I Knew. I'll share this one in the description as well if you want to check it out. Personally, I haven't even gotten a chance to listen myself lately. I've been so busy, but I am going to listen to all these interviews. I'll kind of try to get the highlights for you like I usually do. Those are usually pretty popular videos, so I'll be sure to round those up. But if you want to watch the whole thing, the link is in the description below. Then we also have Colin Canfield from Investor Relations speaking at the 2023 Wells Fargo Industrials Conference if you want to check that out as well. And finally, a little further back on June 6th, this one I did listen to. It was interesting. We had Adam Spice on Stifel Cross Sector Insights Conference. That's another one for you, and I'll make sure that they're all in the description down below. So those are your Rocket Lab updates. There's definitely been a ton going on. Sorry I haven't made as many Rocket Lab videos lately. I've been covering some other space companies as well. Next up, I'm going to do a video on BlackSky, looking at their stock, looking at the company, and trying to see if I think they're a good buy in the Earth observation space. They're kind of a competitor to Planet Labs, the second company in the space industry that I have invested in. Let me know what you think of the updates. Are you convinced that the image I shared was not, in fact, Neutron's landing pad? Let me know down in the comments below. And, I'm pretty excited for Neutron starting to take shape here. If you did find this video useful, I hope you'll consider hitting like, hitting subscribe, and leaving me a comment down below. It all helps with the algorithm. Thank you guys so much. I hope you have a great day. I'll see you in the next video, and bye for now.